Kelly, and today we're making a fun puppet out of recycled materials. So dive into your recycle bin and let's get started. Today's craft are simple and fun, animals or creatures. They're super sweet. They can sit on a countertop, or you can add a stick to it and turn it into a little puppet. I love making these. And today we're only using one toilet paper tube, a pair of scissors, a pencil, and if you want to attach it to a stick, a chapstick or a barbecue skewer or any kind of stick will do. Let's get started. So grab your toilet paper tube and we're going to want to find right where the middle is. I'm going to use a pen so you can see where I'm drawing, but I do suggest that you use a pencil just in case you make a mistake. So draw a line that goes all the way around your tube, just like that. That shows where the body is going to be. And then choose a side where a head should be. Nice and big. Oop, don't forget the ears. Let's see. I'm going to make a cat. Nice, cute kitty ears. There we go. For the legs, we want two in the front and two in the back. So I'm actually going to draw down here at the bottom a bit of a square. That's actually the shape in between the two legs. And then I'm going to draw a leg, a nice rectangle that goes in between the front leg and the back leg. Let's see, where's the back? There we go. Same thing, a square in the back, and then the two lines for the legs. So if you see what I did here, I did the space in between, two legs, a space in between, the two legs, and then that space in between. Don't forget the tail. My cat would never forgive me if I forgot the cat tail. Just going straight up, just like that. You're almost there. Now it's time to cut it out. So to cut this out, because it might be a little hard, I'm gonna start by all the things that go straight up and down first. I think the easiest place is to start right there on that tail. Straight up into the object. Whoop, whoop. And then, because it's gonna be really hard for me to get that angle yet, I'm gonna maybe come over here and cut the side of the head. Aha. Now all I have to do is one straight line in between that tail and the head. Whenever I'm cutting objects, I always try to think of how can I do this the easiest way. Sometimes when you're doing curved things, it gets a little difficult to get those corners. So always going in and then over. Look at that! It looks like it has a hat on. All right, let's cut out those ears. Oh, super cute. My kitty has nice big ears. Very cute. And then now we're gonna just cut out those legs. Remember, it helps just go up, up, and then across. Let's do that every single time. Up, up, then going across. Oh yes, we're almost there, half in the back. Up, up, and then across. And one last set. Up, up, and then across. Oh, these are looking great. If you want to kind of curve the end, the bottom of these feet, so there doesn't have little square feet, sure, why not? That's total a personal preference. It'll still be able to stand. Yeah, my cat does not have square feet. Just kind of cutting off those edges looks nice. This is great. You pretty much already did it. You can always curve or pull that cat tail back. You can even pull the kind of feet out a little bit. If you don't want it to be round, you can smush it so it's more of an oval. And then, of course, the best part, decorating it. Of course, if you want to, you can use googly eyes or pom-pom balls. But remember, those things are not recyclable. So I like to just draw things on. That way, if at any point I'm kind of done playing with this, I can recycle it later. Meow, 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 meow. There we go. Well, have lots of fun. And remember, you can make any fun creature. You can make a lot of them. Oh, I could have a whole tribe of a whole bunch of different pets and animals. They could be friends. You could put a stick on it. If you put a stick on the bottom, like this, coming out, then you can have them kind of dance and be underneath the table.
If you have a stick coming from the top, then you can stand above it and have it move around like that. That's just kind of a fun way to turn it into a puppet. Or it could just be a friend that sits there next to you. Thanks, kitties.
Thanks, puppy.
And have fun. Thanks so much for joining. See y'all later. Bye.